and gentlemen, good early morning as it is, as of right now, past 3 o'clock in the morning. Today, I am going to demonstrate for you how in Las Vegas, you're not at Twin River in Rhode Island, you're not at Mohegan Sun or Black, yeah, obviously the name is Black, I didn't mean to say Black, you're not at Foxwoods or Mohegan Sun in Connecticut, you're not at Twin River Casino in Island. Let's just say you're in Las Vegas and you're trying to learn a good system of betting, and you're not very good at counting cards, but you're trying to learn a system of how to rank up and budget your money and bet wisely. Let's take out a bankroll of 100 nickels. So the first thing the dealer does is burn a card. Queen is burned, as most casinos, or some casinos, burn the card face up. That's how I do it most of the time at my place, as I learned from Foxwoods and Mohegan. We put in a bet of $5. So, we get 8, 9 for the dealer, 13. Now, there are no double downs, there are no splitting pairs, there's no insurance being taken out, or whatever, no surrendering, etc. Now, you have no choice. If you can't double down, you can't split, you can't double down, split, or surrender, or whatever, you have to take a hit on 13 against 9, and you get 2, which adds it up to 15. You have no choice but to take it on the hit, and you have 20. Beautiful. You want to stay. Now, that's a push. Dealer has 20. You have 8 plus 5 is 13 plus 2 is 15 plus 5 is 20. That is a push. Now you want to still bet. Now you want to bet $15. So, you get 6, the dealer's up card is a 2, you have 14 against 2, you gotta stick with the hand you have, 2 through 6, you get 14. So the dealer pulls over a 12, that pulls over a 10 with the 2 and that's 12, hits with an ace, gets 13, and then hits with the queen and busts. So, you get 1, 2, 3 nickels, accumulating up to a total of $30 in the square. So, you have 85 here, that's 100. You just made $15. So now, you go back down to, no you don't go back down. You go up to now $35. I learned this blackjack system from a guy named Al Kaufman, who worked in the casinos in the 1980s in Las Vegas. But anyway, this is 35. So the next hand we have is deuce, 3 showing. All right, you have 12 against 3. Basic strategy says 12 stands against 2 through 6, so we're going to do exactly that. So the dealer pulls over a 10, gets 13, hits with a 5, 18, that's a loss. Now you bet 20. 20 plus 20 is 40, 45, 45 plus 20 is 45 plus 20 is 65, now you bet 75, or if you want to go all in, you bet 80. So, your next card you get is a 7, the dealer's up card is a 3, you get 9. Basic strategy will tell you to hit. All right? So you get 7-7. That's 14 against 3. You have to stick with the hand you have. So if the dealer pulls over 9, he gets 12. Hits with a queen and busts the hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And that's a win. You now just accumulated $180 from 100 of your bankroll. Let's see if that fits into the tray. Yep, that's exactly $100. Here you go. Yep, you made 100, not 180. Wait, no, you made $160. So, you bring it down to 10 to be on the safe side. You now have 150 left in your bankroll. So you get 4, a card king, and a 10. That brings it up to 14. Against king, check for blackjack. Basic strategy will tell you to hit 14 against a 10 value card, and you get 16. Hit again. An unfortunate bust. That's okay. You still have $150. You have 6 slots in a revolver. You shot down like 3. You got 3 bullets left in the gun. 3 bullets left in the gun on the strap of your vest, they call a blackjack strap. Hence the name of blackjack. Anyway. You bet 20, the next card you get to 7, the dealer shows 8. So then you get 7 against 8. You don't split pairs against 8. You don't split 2 sevens, you don't double down. You don't necessarily surrender either. So you have no choice but to take a hit. Mostly you get a 5, 6, or 7 and 7 is 16, so hit again. 7 and 7 is 14, plus 3 is 17, so stay. Whether the dealer has a higher hand than you or not, you still gotta stay on 17. Otherwise, you're just trying to mimic the dealer, thinking you're gonna win when you're not, you're gonna bust. And the dealer has 19. That's an unfortunate mess. So now, to make up for lost effort, the player is going to bet 30. 30 has queen, the dealer has another queen showing, and you have king bringing it up to 20, and the dealer examines his hand to see if there's an ace or whatever under the card, and no, nothing. You got to stay. The dealer has 20, so that's a push. Take out 10, bet 20. 3, dealer shows 3. 9 against 3. I recommend you double down. And you get 9 plus 8, 17. You get 17. So the dealer flips over the whole card, getting 7 with a on a 3 with a 4. It's with a 10, and that's a push. Wouldn't you know? About 2 or 3 pushes in a row. Bringing up to 40. 8. 2 showing. 14. And here's the part I'd like to see as willing to take a risk. If I hit with a 5, 6, or 7, I'll be lucky. So here goes the end result. I hit with a 2, 8, 16. And that's as far as I'm going to go. 16 against 2, I'm going to stay. So the dealer flips over the whole card with his 2, gets an 8, and adds up to 10, hits with 9, and loses. poop-poop-dee-doo, I only have $90 left. I'm short $10. So because I'm short $10, I'm betting double $10 to get even. The player has a 9, dealer shows 9. Ooh, look at that. 3 times I matched up a certain rank of a card with another rank of a card, and I didn't even play for the match option, like in today's modern casinos. But that's not what we're here to do. We're here to accumulate a system of playing blackjack, where we size up our bets little by little, hand by hand, round to round, and see if we can go at least $10 or $5 over our bank limit without going over 21. So anyway, the player has a 9, I have a 9, the dealer has a 9. That's a 7, which it gets to 16. Now you can't surrender, you can't double down, you're not even going to split pairs in this game, so you have no choice but to take a hit. And you bust. So that's $30 here. I'm short $30, bringing it down to $70. 70 minus 20. You have half your bankroll left over. So you're betting 20. So the first card you get is an ace. Whoa. Good luck. You get a 9 for the dealer. Okay, so basic strategy is going to tell you to stay on 20 or 10 against a 9, which I deem this to be a hard 10, a 10, 20, really, a soft 20, not a 10 or a 20, but a soft 20, so I stay. Dealer flips over his whole card, gets 16, hits with king, and busts his hand. Again. Back up to $90 total, leaving me still short of $10. $10. Ace, old card. An incredible blackjack. Alright? Pay the blackjack. I'll take even money this time. Not an extra $5 chip. So as we get lucky, we're going to bet the full 9 yards. Either we win and the video continues, or we lose and all production stops. So here goes nothing. The first card the player gets in this round is a 6. Jack for the dealer. King. No, Jack for the 6. The 16. Dealer's aim is the hand for blackjack, and oops, the show's over. Sorry. That is a loss. That's it for next time. Until next time. Excuse my words. I had a brain fart. Until next time. That is all.
So viva Las Vegas. Roll credits. Viva, oh, viva Las Vegas.